What's going on, guys? It's Danny here, and welcome to episode 2 of Leveling a Pandaren Monk. Remember in the first episode? Damn, it's so weird to talk like in episodes. This is the first time ever I'm making some kind of series, you know? It's kind of strange, I don't know. In the first one, we made the character, leveled it up to level 5. So, let's go. Let's go and see where we left it and continue leveling up a little bit. If you haven't seen the first episode, I will leave an annotation for a few seconds up here above my camera. If you want to go and check that one out before watching this one, the second one. So, yeah, we came here and then we took quests. So there are quests to do. And remember how I said it's a lot easier to go for the one first, and in the meantime, until you get there, you will complete the others as well. So aim for the one first. And that one is ring the training bell. Okay, so we have to go and ring the training bell. And meanwhile, as you can see, there are things here that we're gonna be taking. There are some things I wanted to talk about in this video. Oh, by the way, wait, I can log out for a second. Just for a second to show you. You saw it in the previous screen. But I can log out for just a second and show you. My main character, my Shadow Priest, is finally here on this realm, you know? Realm. I saw in the comments of episode 1... someone said realm. Yeah, that's how you say it. This is my priest. This is my main character, basically. This is what I played 4 years ago. I also have like a mage warrior, but this shadow priest is for me the funniest, like the most fun thing to play right now. Or it's always been, and I think it always will be. I don't know, unless somehow I fall in love with this monk and then I start playing the monk a lot. Oh, hello there. What's up? Okay. I saw in the comments of my first episode someone said realm, because I say realm, but apparently it should be like realm. Oh shit. Okay, so if you say it's realm, then realm. Also, someone else said that this up here, you know, the yellow bar is the energy of our character, and below that there is these points here. I was saying Kai, someone in the comments said it's Ki. I mean, key. I kind of looked at it on the internet. I think it comes from Chinese, and the perfect pronunciation would be something like chi, like a chi, you know. But even key is still good, I guess. How do I get to the training bell? I think I'm gonna be jumping on these things. I'm gonna have to jump on these things to get to the jumping bell. To the training bell, I mean. Because otherwise, how do I get there? Okay, I see. Alright, there we go. Damn. Okay, did you hear the bell? Maybe I can lower a little bit the microphone. I can lower it. I don't know if I'm being too loud. Tell me if I'm being too loud, if the sound is okay. We have one quest left to do out of the 3 that we took. So, defeat 6 of something. Oh, we have to defeat these guys up here. Okay. Okay, I can do it from here. Okay, another one. I keep forgetting to use my roll, by the way. There is something I'm gonna do here. I think I'm gonna put the blackout kick on F. I have here, I have F, R, V, G, you know. So on F, it usually I put on F my most spammable spell. And then I kind of want to have the row on 4. I just want to have them like this. You can put them in whatever whatever way or whatever order you want. And if you press escape and you go to the key bindings, here you can put all kinds of key bindings for different things. So you can change your movement keys and stuff. You can change everything you want. So you can set up hotkeys for your spells. Usually it goes from 1 to 9, usually. And then it goes, and then it has like the equal sign of your keyboard. But instead of that, I have F. Oh, let me get up here and kill this. Alright, die. 4 out of 6. Jump here and kill this guy. Need to kill 2 more. So, yeah, one thing I wanted to say. You guys, in the comments of the first video told me some things that I'm not pronouncing right. And then people who tell me something that I'm not pronouncing right, after that they kinda apologize in a way. Just wanted to tell you, no problem, it's actually helpful. No need to apologize in a way or something like that, or no need to feel bad for telling me how to say something right, because you know, English is my third language, and it's not that good. My English is not that good, I'm aware of that. So it's actually helpful when you tell me. So, because I was saying realm, but apparently it's pronounced realm, so now I can say everything properly, right? My shadow priest is finally on this realm. Seems good. Row. I forget to row, man. Keep forgetting to row. And then the key instead of Kai. And now we take another quest. Speak to old man. Okay. I'm gonna speak to old man and he is right there. Did she just level up? Yeah, she leveled up. She's a Pandaren monk too. Pandaren monk. Leather, equip. There is... Damn, I forgot what I wanted to say. I was gonna talk about other stuff. Other than the pronunciation things. Something also I might do for this character is I might get some sick upgrades, and I really mean sick upgrades in a sense of gear, because when you have a main character, with it you can unlock gear that scales, basically gear that gets better and better with every level. That's the advantage of having a main character, and then, you know, this being my alt, like alt, my second character and third character. So we have a quest, now we have two quests to go and slay. And then there is one, the sun something. There is one up there. So we're gonna go for the one first. Do we have something to equip here? Nah, not really. I might get some really good upgrades in a sense of gear. There are like a head, back, weapons, you know, rings, chest, all kinds of stuff that you can buy with your main character. It requires something. Looks like it's changed from 4 years ago when I played this game. It's changed, so you it might require like a bit more than before to get those items, but basically it's gear that scales with levels. It gives you certain amount of stats. We're gonna have to kill this guy, right? Otherwise he will attack us. Yeah. Okay, one. That's gear that scales with levels. I haven't talked about stats yet. In this game, there are stats or attributes, the right way of saying it, I guess, attributes. Agility, stamina, armor, critical strike, you know, and there are also gear. In the very beginning, the very basic gear from quests gives you only armor, but later when you keep playing the game, when you get to level 12, 15 or so, the gear you get from quests or doing dungeons, or just regular mobs, you know, anything can drop any kind of gear. So those, you will see how they give you attributes, you know. It can give you stamina and stuff like that. What is in here? Water prints? Water pincer? Something? What do we have to kill here? I don't see them. Like, I'm on top of the quest. I am right on top of the quest on my map. It's the blue area is where your quest is, where the things you have to kill are located over here in the blue area. But I don't, maybe it's this one, but it doesn't say it. No, it's not that one. Okay, let's move a little bit, move up there and see if there is something up there. Row. Oh, there they are. Okay, there they are. See on the bottom right of the screen, when you just point at one of them on the bottom right of the screen, it says up here. I mean, down here. It says 0 out of 6 for the quest. So this is how you see you have the quest. Roll and punch him, and then with the F. By the way, I should have mentioned that earlier, I guess. If you didn't watch episode 1 and you just found this one, you just found my episode 2. In the first one, we learned some spells. Roll is basically a roll, you already saw it. This one, the blackout kick, deals a lot of damage and consumes the ki. And this one, the Tiger Palm, is a basic ability with not so much damage, but it consumes the energy and it creates ki. So one, consume energy and create ki, and then F here, consume the ki and deal a lot of damage. That's basically what we're doing right now. Imagine when we get to level like 50, 60, 70, we will have so many spells that, man, just like every other hero, every other class in the game. Alright, I don't know why am I hesitating so much. I can go for 3 of them at the same time. Did we just level up, or that already happened earlier? Did we level 6, yeah. The next spell we get is at level 8, which is a healing spell. That's great to have a heal, to heal myself when I fight against like 5 mobs at the same time. At the end I will be low HP, so I can heal myself. Okay, let's go and return the quests. By the way, if you have been following my channel for a long time, you would know that this is the first series I'm making. And also, this is like the third or fourth time ever I'm commentating over a World of Warcraft video. So, I'm sorry if I don't say things with the right name, because I watched my episode 1. And sometimes instead of quests, I say mission. I'm gonna get it right very soon. I'm gonna get used to it very soon, I promise you. And everything will be fine. Okay, 6 armor, much better than the one we had before. This one is only 3 armor. Quest is cross to pull. Okay. So I have to go in the center of the pool and drop this thing, right? I have to be like here. Oh wait, my hero automatically jumped. I didn't jump. Pool of reflection. This one, this thing here? Let me see. Oh, okay, okay, my bad. There it is. Hello? So this is... Something is going to happen here. We are about to see something happening. Because I have to return the quest, but I don't see anyone on the map. So he has to appear here. So let's see what's going to happen here. What are you doing, man? Just let me return the quest and continue leveling. We don't want to sit here forever. Yeah, in episode 1, sometimes instead of quest, I was saying mission. Kinda weird, I don't know. I don't know where that came from. Missions? You do missions in games like GTA, right? GTA 5, there are missions. Don't tell me the quest. Oh my god, okay, I've been waiting for nothing. Some of the quests, when you click on them, you have the complete quest option. You don't have to speak to anyone. You just either click on the quest here, or you go to your map and then you see the quest here, and then complete quest. Complete quest. And now, water walk into 5 something. So, we're gonna walk. Oh, okay, this is what we have to do. Oh, okay, this is why this little thing is creating those water... I don't know what they are. So I have to walk on them. And this is gonna push me out, right? Push me up, I mean. Yeah. Why are you laughing? What is so funny about this? She's laughing at me. Or... I don't know if that's a she. Looks like a kid or something. You can also make your character laugh, by the way. I'm gonna show you in a second. If you type in the chat, slash laugh, you can also dance, slash dance, or slash hello, and then your character says hello to someone or something. You can hear my panda and laugh like this. Laugh. Ho 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 ho. And then you can make him dance. Slash dance. There it is. Look at that. Look at those moves, baby. Okay, let's go, quest. 4 armor. Much better than the one we had before. Speak to someone. Okay, we're gonna go speak to him. Oh, wow. He is pretty far away. Or she, I don't know. Pretty far away, so we're gonna have to be walking all the way there. Another thing that I do sometimes when I have to walk somewhere, you can press your block number block. I have a Spanish keyboard, so I don't know how is it exactly. The number block of your keyboard, you know, on the right side of your keyboard, you have these numbers, and there is one key that you can block them and, you know, block them and then enable them and disable them. If you click that one, your hero moves forward and you don't have to touch anything. I'm not pressing W right now, as you can see, and my hero is moving. So you can just put your hero to move like this, and then you control with A and D to the sides you want to go and stuff, and Q and E. Some people use Q and E. That's a little bit more advanced if you want to get out of your... I mean, if you want to get more out of your hotkeys and stuff, but don't think about if you just started playing the game right now. That's a little bit more advanced. You can also move your hero by pressing the scroll button of your mouse, okay? So, you press the scroll button, and then when you move your mouse left and right, your hero also goes left and right. And some people do that, and then they put Q and E on spells. But I don't do that. I'm used to using Q and E to move my hero left and right side, and then A and D to rotate the camera left and right side, right? Sorry if I'm giving too much information. Like, I don't wanna, like, I want to give tips and stuff like that, so those of you who are like completely new to the game can learn some stuff. But I don't want to like non-stop feed information that way too much information, and you won't be able to remember everything. That's not how you learn stuff. You can learn stuff slowly and surely, not like listening to me 1 hour of non-stop information feeding to your head. You're not gonna remember absolutely everything. What do we have to do on these quests? One is plump something slain. So basically we have to kill these rats. Those are rats. And then unpruded turnip, stolen carrot. Okay, so we have to steal carrots. Oh, hello. Die. I forget to roll, man. I keep forgetting to roll. You have to get used to your characters, you know? You have to use the roll. You have to use what your characters have. Oh, there is a carrot right there that we can steal. To be honest, the way I play is I use a combination of everything. I hold the scroll of the mouse, and then I also press S. So when you press both W and S, your hero doesn't go anywhere. I don't press W and S, but when you press the scroll the scroll of your mouse, it's the same like pressing W, because your character goes forward. And then I kind of just rotate like this, you know, move around, and then use E and Q. Okay, let's steal the carrot here, and then we have to do other things as well. I don't see any quest objectives over here. One more carrot over there that we have to get. So, about the gear that... Wait. Maybe I have to keep going up here. Yeah, I think I will go up there. The gear that scales. It's really helpful. It gives you bonus experience. Wanna consider that as some kind of cheating, maybe? Well, I don't know. That's the advantage of having a main character. And then this being your second or third character, right? Because with your main, you can buy that gear. You will see. Right now, I cannot send anything on the mail to this character because I haven't chosen a faction yet. I haven't chosen if I want to be Horde or Alliance. I think it's pretty obvious that we will be Horde. Some of you might already know that we will be Horde because my main is Horde. And on this realm that I'm playing right now is mainly Horde realm. It's like 90% probably of the characters are all Horde. This is why I moved to this this realm. It has a lot of people. It's like the most popular Horde realm from the EU, from all Europe, basically. Okay. Roll, Danny. Roll, Danny. You have roll. Come on. Use 4. Remember to use 4. Remember to use the roll. There it is. And we have to go for the last objective, which is right there. I can see it. I lost it. Okay, no. Oh yeah, I wanted to talk about professions. I saw this thing right here. Where is it? See what I'm selecting right now? Up there. This is herbalism, I believe. It's called. I'm not sure if I'm saying it right. This right here thing. See, requires herbalism. There are professions in the game. I don't think we wanna learn and like level up any profession because it's gonna take forever. Actually, maybe over time, when I haven't played, maybe they made leveling professions easier. Before, it used to be kind of like a little bit boring process to level professions, and pretty time consuming because you had to do so much stuff. And you know, it's not that it's hard. Leveling a profession is not hard, but it could be really time consuming at times. And it could get kind of annoying and boring sometimes. But having a profession is definitely a big advantage. You can craft gear with different professions. There are different professions that are really good on different characters. So you can craft gear with professions. Okay, so we have to kill one more of those. See again how I went for the 3 first? I had to collect 3 stolen carrots and then 3 of something else and then 3 of something else. So I went for that one first. And then on the meantime, I just killed the rats. Rabbit. No, they are not rabbits. They are rats, kind of. These are some kind of rats. I don't know. Whatever. Basically, the thing is, when you have to slay something, when you have to kill something or collect something, leave it for the end and doing it in the meantime until you get to something that's a bit harder. Six armor, the previous one we had gives 5 armor. This is not even a big deal, like this kind of items. Or this kind of gear is not even that big of a deal, you know. I really need to find what's it called? A place to sell my stuff. Level 7, boys. Recover something. Okay, so we're gonna have to go and recover something. And there is another quest over here that we have to take. Gather 12. Okay. This one. Right here. So, I have to sell everything that I don't need. Which is basically everything that I have in my inventory. Except the Hearthstone. You can't even sell your Hearthstone. And that's something I didn't mention in episode 1. I like putting my Hearthstone over here on these bars. Okay, so we're going for the 1 first. And then the 12. The 1 first. You have a Hearthstone. Basically returns you it has a 30 minute cooldown. It used to be 1 hour cooldown before, now it's 30 minutes. So it's better if it's actually 30 minutes than 1 hour. 1 hour seemed too long. They made it 30 minutes, that's amazing. Okay, this is the quest guy. And around the quest guy we have the other quest to do. So let's go and kill him. I'm gonna get Kai's and then consume the Kai's to deal damage. And then energy again, Kai's again, or keys, sorry. Hey, where are you going? What the hell? Stop running. He's trying to juke me here. Alright. This thing shows us a quest person or quest guy, but I actually didn't complete the quest when I killed him. Oh, there it is. Never mind. I had to collect something of him. So now I'm gonna take those. Damn, we are 30 minutes into the video already. How much bullshit have I said until now? Later I'm gonna check out the video again, just like I did with episode 1. You know, one not so good thing is that I cannot repeat the video if I think that I didn't do it perfectly. Because you cannot go back. Like, I leveled up to 7, I cannot reset the game and start from level 5 to where I started the episode. So, I record the video once and that's it. This is what I upload. At the same time, you know, it's kinda cool because it doesn't take all day. Like, for example, the Dota gameplays. In Dota, I need to play, like, I don't know, 5 games plus or something. Sometimes 3-4 games are enough to get one good to upload, but a lot of the times not even 5 are enough to upload one. Doesn't matter. Okay. Request. Help in... Okay. So we're gonna have to go and request help from someone. This guy here. Can you wake up Wuguo for me? Can you wake up Wuguo for me? Okay, that was it. Oh no, I have to wait here, I think. Yeah, I have to wait here. So 33 minutes into the video, it's been 33 minutes. Time flies. With this thing, time flies, honestly. If you have been enjoying the video so far, wouldn't hurt if you leave a like, right? I mean, wait, that's probably not the right way of asking for it. Would be really nice if you leave a like on the video. Would help out the video, you know? The more likes, the more and the better ratings a video has, the better chances it has to grow and reach out to more people and get more popular. If you are enjoying this video or any video that watch from my channel, if you honestly have a good time watching that video, just please, it would be really nice leaving a like on that video, and that way you are supporting my channel. You are helping me out a lot and I would appreciate that. Need some water. Jesus. I'm gonna die without water. What is this thing making me go all the way up there? Come on, man. You know, I wanted to do... in this gameplay, I wanted... or let's play. Wait, I didn't say in the beginning of the video let's play. Wow, god damn it. I said welcome to leveling a Pandaren monk. Let's play. Wow. Welcome to another let's play WoW episode. This is episode 2. Leveling a Pandaren monk. Man, honestly, I have been enjoying the Pandaren zone. The Pandaren, honestly, it's amazing. It's pretty big, to be honest. Look at how much it is. I don't know if here, this part of the map, I don't know if you even go there and you have quests in there, but the rest of it is pretty big and it's just pretty cool. It looks really, really beautiful. I find it really amazing. Complete quest. Meet with someone. Oh, whoa, whoa, what are you doing? What are you doing? Okay, I'm gonna have to go there. So I guess this wind thingy is going to help me go there. And meanwhile, I equip the wrist that we got and the feet. Hey, Dakonk, this way. Okay, they are even showing me where to go. Alright, cool. I mean, I would go anyway. I would know where to go, but nice. So, my plan for this Let's Play episode 2 was to level up to 10 or something. Or level up to the point. I guess it's level 10. Level up to the point where we can select a faction, you know. We can select if we want to be Horde or Alliance. So we can select a Horde. That was my plan, but I don't know. So far it's 37 minutes video. Oh, also, tell me, what do you think would be a good duration for this series? On my channel, you can see videos that are like between, you know, Dota gameplays can be 35, you know, 40, 45, up to an hour. I have had games that are hours long, 1 hour and a half. I think my longest game in Dota 2 is 1 hour and 60 or 70 minutes or something long. I don't remember exactly. So my Dota 2 videos could be between 30, 35 and even to 1 hour. My Overwatch that I recently started making, the Overwatch gameplays, is basically the duration of one competitive match, which could be between 18 and 25, max 30 minutes. And now I'm wondering how long World of Warcraft Let's Plays should be. How long? Burn 5 Defected Scroll of Wisdom. Okay, so we gotta go there and burn this. Also, I got new quests. If you look at the map, you can see that you get quests. This normally happens when you discover a new zone, right? Until now, I was here, and they sent me to come here and talk to this person here. So you basically discover a new zone over here, and be sure you look at your map on the top right, because after you speak to the guy and he gives you one quest, there are other people here that give you other quests. I mean, obviously these are not real people, real players, but you understand what I mean when I say people. Okay, so we're gonna be level 8 very soon. The first episode was like 46 minutes, right? Something like that. I can make this 1 hour. I think I can make this one go up to 1 hour or so. My plan was to level up to level 10, honestly, and select the faction that we want. But I don't know how long that's going to take. In the beginning of the game, when you are leveling up, it's really fast. Really fast in the beginning and easy. But after that, it gets a bit slower and a bit harder. That's why I'm going to need the help of those, you know, items that I will buy with my main. Wait, did he just... mages? This guy is a mage. And he gets that spell so early? I remember you used to get that spell later. And he has a frost bolt and stuff. Oh, why am I not helping him? Wait a second. Okay, and then we both get items from the mob. You know, it doesn't matter so much because it's in the past. That's how the game used to be before. But before it was pretty annoying for leveling in servers that have a lot of people, because once you stack, like once you start attacking this guy and then there is another player that also wants to kill this guy, he can't get anything from it, right? That's how it used to be. He can't get anything from it because it's mine. And right now, as you can see, this one, we killed him. We killed him both at the same time. So both of us got the quest item that we are collecting. Okay, I have to burn this. And then I have to go and burn one more. And then I have to defeat that one up there. Because it's already half HP. This guy made it pretty easy for us. Come here. Come here, monkey. So yeah, tell me in the comments, what do you think? How long should be this kind of a video, let's play WoW video? I think around 40 minutes is good, right? It's good enough. I really wanted to reach level... really wanted to reach level 10 in this episode too. But I guess it's not going to happen. I think we level up to level 8 and then we leave it for the next one. At the same time though, there is nothing to hurry up for, right? Am I saying that right? Nothing to hurry up about? Nothing to hurry up for? No reason to rush things, basically? Like, this is basically our series. And series are supposed to be... Well, maybe I shouldn't say that. Not all series are supposed to be long. It's not like they are supposed to be long, but they could be long. So, we don't have to rush as fast as possible. I don't want to make like 1 hour long videos and then you guys get bored. At half of the video duration, you get bored and you stop watching. This is supposed to be like some kind of like maybe relaxing content. I don't know, relaxing video. I don't know. Three quests. This guy has three quests for me. By the way, we got the new spell. This is the heal, so let's use the heal and see how it works. 128. See, on the top left, right here where my character is, you can see the heal. See, 64, 64, 64. So this consumes energy. This is so interesting and so, like, so strange at the same time, because I'm used to... I have played healers before, and when I played healers, it used to be mana, like consuming mana. And right now, to heal people, I'm using energy. I can heal this player over here. I can heal her. She doesn't really need it, but I can heal her if I wanted to. So this consumes energy. Now, here we have spells to deal damage, right? I don't want to have the heal between that spells that deal damage. I want to have it in a different bar. So actually you can click here, okay? You can click here and you have a second bar. See how it's two here, one, two. And I can put it here on the second bar. Also, what you can do to get it is use shift and then your mouse, your scroll of the mouse, and then you scroll through your different bars. This is bar one, the main one, DPS. And when I switch to the other one, I have the heal. Seems good to me, right? Like this. So slowly we are getting more and more things, you know. We got the Hearthstone up here. This is something you get at level 1 when you create your character. But I just didn't mention it in episode 1. So I'm gonna go get the quests and then I will end the gameplay here, or the let's play. Or actually I could do more quests. And it gives me a staff that's much better than the one I had before. Kill 20 of those. Actually, fuck it. Let's go and do the quests. Let's go do these 3 quests. And then we will see what happens. I hope it lets me select the faction after that. And finally go Horde. But maybe it will let me go Horde like... later at level 10 or something. Not exactly at 8 or 9. Alright, so get this, and there is another quest here. Another quest over there. Bring the jade, okay. So this is basically, I have to bring it to the village, to where I get my quests from. Okay, we have to slay 4 of these, or 20 of these. 20. And then 8 stolen, and then one of those that we have to slay. Okay, so we're going for the one. Always aim for the one. Go for the one. And then in the meantime, you will collect stuff. And you will kill stuff at the same time. Let's go for more. Let's go crazy a little bit. Let's go 4 at the same time. Take these 2 and these 2 over here. I can heal myself later. And also I have this thing helping me right now. This is not a player, by the way. This is something from the game that's helping me with the quest. Makes sense that they made it something to help you with the quest. Because you have to kill 20. It's not like killing one or something. You have to kill 20. So... getting help with the quest is kinda cool. Oh my god, I'm not noticing my... I'm gonna roll. I'm gonna heal myself. Jesus Christ, dude. I'm not noticing my HPs. This is exactly the reason why I pulled like 5 or 6 of them at the same time. Because I have heal now. On level 8, we learned the heal. So... I can heal myself, but I forgot for a second, and I almost died. Okay, there is the one that we have to kill. That one is right there. But meanwhile, we have others attacking us, so we're gonna do that. No, left something for me. Use the keys. Create more key and then keep using them. It's a pretty big spam of buttons. Just spam buttons like crazy. Monks remind me of rogues. I had a rogue. I'm a pretty bad rogue player. That's why my main is not a rogue. But I have played Rogue before. rogues also have energy and they have similar spells and they have similar attributes, like they also work with agility and critical strike and stuff. It's pretty cool how the person with the quest is next to me instead of having to go to the village. Cross the ropes and speak to someone. Okay. See you at the dock. Okay. I don't know what the dock is, but see you there. At the same time, this is helping me learn English a little bit. I definitely need that. My English is not perfect. What's happening here? Who is throwing fireworks at me? What is this? One second, my mom. Okay. Cross. Okay, we have to cross here. We're going to be level 10 now. Level 9. Oh, come on, man. What the fuck? I gotta be more careful here. Let's see if she is gonna do it. Let's see if she goes down like me. How did she level up like that in the meantime, just by walking? Oh my god, I almost rolled down. Almost fucked up with the roll. Okay, we leveled up, boys. Speak to Dafeng. Okay, I'm gonna go speak to him. Oh my god, he's so far away. In the comments of Let's Play episode 1 of leveling this monk, in the comments I told you, you know, I asked you if you wanted me to keep recording after I leave the Pandaren zone or just until the Pandaren zone. Everyone said you want after, basically to keep recording until I get like level 110 or something. This is perfect, you know. I will have more content to upload for you guys. So what was I gonna say? Damn it. I actually forgot what I was gonna say. Oh yeah. I told you in that comment that I can show you the dungeons. I think in the next episode already, we might be able to do dungeon. The very first dungeon, I think, starts at level 12. Level 12 or 15, I'm not 100% sure. If it starts at level 15, then it will be later on, episode 4 or so. Not in 3. Oh, whoa, whoa, what is going on in here? Oh, shit, I'm dying. Release spirit. Oh, what the hell, man? Oh, okay. See? This is why you should pay attention to the game. Because she said, wait. We need to wait for the winds to settle. But I didn't wait for the winds to settle. I just rushed in and I died like an idiot. So, if you never played World of Warcraft, now you get to see what happens when you die. You release your spirit and then you have to walk back to where you died. So, that's it. And then I'm gonna heal myself. Because I have the ability to heal myself. Okay, we need to wait for the winds to settle down, then make a break for the cover of the far. Okay, whatever. Gotta wait. Okay, we're gonna wait. Oh, wait me. I'm gonna roll. I'm rolling. Apparently when you jump and then you roll, it's very inefficient. Because you almost roll nothing. But if you're just walking and then you roll, it's like a lot more. You get more from the roll. Okay, perfect. Defeat someone. Okay. I think this is a pretty nice place to leave it, right? So I might actually take this as a thumbnail. The thumbnail of the video, you know? I might do something like, this is how I did the thumbnail of episode 1. I made the camera closer, and then as I said in episode 1, when you press Alt Z, you hide everything and you can only see your character and the rest of the screen. And then I take a screenshot, but I have to go to the interface and names and remove my name because it looks kind of ugly in the thumbnail of the video. And I can do something like, oh, like this. Yeah. Say hi. Say cheese for the screenshot. Okay, screen captured. Well, well, that's it. I'm gonna log out here. We left it at level 9. So that was episode 2, guys, of leveling a Pandaren monk. We got from level 5 to level 9. It took almost 1 hour. Not so bad, not so bad. 1 hour for 4 levels. It's nice. Later when I get the leveling gear that scales with levels, it will be a little bit faster because I will be getting bonus experience from it. Consider that a little bit like some kind of cheating. I don't know. That's the advantage of having a main character, you know. I'm pretty excited to play my main. I will be playing my main later tonight. Right now it's 3:43 p.m. later at night. After I'm done streaming some Dota 2 and recording some stuff, maybe I will be like streaming Dota 2 and whatever, doesn't matter much. I will play on my main after that. My main is level 101. I have to get it to 110 and then do world quests and do dungeons, normal dungeons and heroic dungeons, and start getting gear. So maybe anytime soon in the future I can do raids as well and go to you know, raids are really cool. There is just so much things to do on the main. There are so many things to do. On this one it's just leveling up, it's very simple, but on my main there are so many things to do. Anyway, so thank you for watching this Let's Play episode 2, Let's Play World of Warcraft. I will see you guys in the next one. Good luck and have fun playing video games.